So in this video, we'll be doing the spectra box from Hack the Box, and the IP address is 10.10.10.229. And I have already run the nmap scan. You can see SSH port is open and web server and MySQL. So let's go to this index page, and you can see issue tracking until IT setup the Jira. We can configure and use this for issue tracking. Press Ctrl U. So there are no other comments. So let's open this software issue tracker and also open this test. So there is nothing in this index.php. So let's run the GoBuster on this. So it's it will redirect to the spectra.htb. All you need to do is so edit this host file and add this IP address 10.10.10.229 to the spectra.htb and www.spectra.htb. So let's run this scan meanwhile, so we can view the main page. So this seems like a WordPress. Yes, it's WordPress and by administrator. So there is one user administrator, and you can click on this post to see if there are any other user, or you can go to wp-json. So I think wp-json, and you need to specify HTTP. So otherwise it is it's being treated as a search keyword, so not found. And WordPress commenter, there is no username for this, so that means only administrator user. So click on login. Okay, meanwhile in the testing also there is some WordPress. So let's view for directory listing. If there is a directory indexing, we should see all the pages. And now you can see there is a, this is the testing website. After testing here, they have published it to this main branch. And now you can see one word, one file. You can view the contents is .save file. So normally you cannot read the PHP file because it's rendered by the server, and you won't get any information in the browser. So let's go to this, and in the save file there is empty. Press Ctrl U, and now we have the config.php. So this is the database credentials, dev user. Okay, what is this? Okay, the database name is dev and the user is dev test, and the password is dev team 01. So let's try this password. So before finding this one, before finding any contents in this testing, I have run the the XML RPC brute force attack. It did not search for the password because it's dev team 01. So now click on login. So you can see we are successfully logged in. So there is a CSS did not load properly. So anyway, you can click on theme editor. So select some 2017 theme and select this. So click on this 404.php. And now put this PHP system. Put this single quote for safety, because in the previous boxes we put the double quote, we got some error. So get our CMD. So this should do it. Now click on update file. so it's taking a while. So file rated successfully. Now I can copy this and go to WP content and themes. So what theme we have rated, it's 2017 I think, so 2017 and then 404.php, passing the cmd is equals to who am I. Copy this. So you can see we got this Nginx user. Let's say which python 3. So Python should be installed, I think. Where is Python? So there is Python. Maybe which command has not been installed or disabled. So there is Python 2 and Python 3. So we are good. Let's stop this directory brute force. So you can grab the Python reverse shell from Pentest Monkey. And it's residing on port 3333. So Python. And now we get the shell. Let's import pty and let's spawn the bash. So now you can see we have some decent terminal. So go back to themes, go back to WP content, ls. So go back ls. So now you can view the cat actual configuration, the updated configuration, and its password is development 01. So let's copy this and let's go to cd home. Ls, and there are so many users, right? So let's go to let's try this password on this KT user. So we know that SSH is open, right? SSH KT. Maybe that's not the password. Okay, that password is not for KT user. So let's say LSLA and LSKT. So let's say LSLAKT and we cannot read the user.txt. Okay. So let's go to root directory. And I have run the lint piece and it shows me that there is some unusual files in the opt. So let's go to the opt. So you can see there is some another configuration file. So let's view the contents of this. So it is so there is this folder hc auto login and it is trying to read the contents from the current directory. So it is going into these three directories, and every time it's going into the directory, if not equal to directory password, so there should be some password in this folder. So let's go to this and say ls, and there is a password. So somewhere here comes. So this is maybe the password for the KT user. So now we have logged in as a KT successfully. So since we have the password, let's say sudo l. So you need CTR. So this is a new privilege escalation technique I have learned while doing this box. So this initctl is used to manage the uptime scripts. So if you go to cdhc init and let's say ls, so here are these are the jobs. So they can be run whenever your Linux system has been started. Okay, so whenever there is a event triggered, like any other SSH user has been logged in, so this may be triggered, we don't know, it's based on the conditions the administrator have written. So these jobs can be run with this initctl. So okay, so let's see, you can run this as a sudo and there will be no password, let's say minus h. So first let's try the help before this help actually shows us the commands how to start these jobs and stop these jobs. So you can start, stop, restart, reload, and we can query for the status and also list the jobs. So let's list the jobs. And you can see here there's suppose say Bluetooth D and start running and process 2642. So this is the process ID and it's in the state either start or running. So that means we have the process ID, it is running. And another one, let's take example stop or waiting. So that means it either been stopped or waiting to be continued. Okay. So now if you observe, there is a test 2. Okay, and so there should be yes, there is the test job and test one job. So what we can do is we can try to edit this configuration first. Let's say nano nano test.conf. So okay, this is the description, test node.js server. So whenever the computer is starting, so this script gets executed, so these three commands gets executed every time. So you can see the job have different states, it may have like 5 to 10 states, like pre-start, pre-stop, post-start and post-stop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete these three lines and put in some code. If you put at the fourth line, your command does not get executed because this here will start up the server and it will continuously run. So that's why we are going to delete all this. And what we are going to do is echo KT all commands is equals to all no password all. So this should be appended to hc sudo ls. Okay, this should do fine. So let's copy this. And now we can start the test. So let's view again the configuration file. So okay, let's now run the sudo l. Now we can run all the commands as a root user without password. So who am I? Root. So we show you one important thing here. So if you go to the root directory, that is root.txt and also a script.sh. So let's view this. Because first I tried to edit the test2.configuration, but I got error. So you can see the code here. It is constantly copying the test2.configuration to this test and test1 to 10 files for every like 60 seconds, I think so. So if you edit this test1.configuration, so automatically after 1 minute, this will be replaced by the original one. So be careful in editing this. Better try to edit the test.configuration.